Thanks for joining me on Cooking for Real today, where I'm going to be making a Parmesan garlic braided loaf. This recipe actually started out as individual buns, but they don't keep well. They dry out too fast. So this is the new and improved version. Now, before we get started, if you could like, share, comment, subscribe, I'd really appreciate it. On to the bread making. First things first, I have actually already chopped this up. This is fresh parsley. It's about 2/3 of a bunch of parsley from the store, and each of these is 2.5 tablespoons, so I did take it and divide it. Part of this is going in the bread, and part of this is going in the ripple. We're going to bloom the yeast. I have a medium-sized bowl here that is room temperature, and then I have 2 cups of warm water. Now that warm water should be between 95 and 110 degrees. Into that I am putting 2 teaspoons and 1/4 of yeast. I have stopped using plain white sugar in bread making, and instead I replace the amount of sugar that should go in it with honey. This is 1 tablespoon of honey. So I'm just going to mix this in, and then what we're going to do is let it sit 3 to 5 minutes until this yeast starts bubbling. As you can see here, this yeast has gone nice and foamy, and into this yeast we're going to add, this is 4 tablespoons or 1/2 of a stick of melted butter, and then 2 teaspoons of kosher salt. And this is where we're going to add our first cup of flour directly into this liquid. This will be basically our bread starter. Now here you're going to see that there's already some parsley in the bowl of this food processor, but that's okay because I'm putting parsley in the bread dough itself. So let's add that bread starter in and 1 cup of flour. Pop the lid on. I'm gonna give it a couple of quick pulses and then I'm gonna let it go. This is the point where I'm going to add that 2.5 tablespoons of parsley and 2.5 tablespoons of dried minced garlic. Taking the lid off because it's kind of difficult to pour flour through that tiny little hole on top. That's 3 cups in. This will be the 4th cup. Now you can see it's starting to form a ball in here and pulling away from the sides. So we're gonna add 1/2 cup. The goal is 5 1/4 cups. But some of this you're going to knead in by hand. You can see there's actually a lot of parsley in this bread, but I have to tell you, in bread, when you add flavor, you have to add a lot. Otherwise, it just gets lost in the yeast and flour. So what I'm doing right now is a gentle knead on the counter with the rest of the flour. This is the best way to incorporate the last bit of flour. And bread requires a lot of kneading. This is actually going to get worked over for 15 minutes. So what I'm going to do now is stop the cameras and we'll come back when this is closer to being a bread dough. You can see now that this is holding its shape really nicely. And let me bring this over to you and show you all of those gorgeous bits of flavoring in there. Look at, there's no wrinkles in here, no creases. It is become bread. Now what I am going to do, I am going to sprinkle a little olive oil in the bowl, give it a nice coating. This goes in the bowl. It also gets a little wiped down. And that's just to prevent it from becoming dry. A sheet of plastic wrap. And then we are going to pop this into a warm, dry place for at least an hour. We want this to double in size. As a matter of fact, I'm gonna loosen this a little bit so if it pops up above the surface of the bowl, it's not strained by the plastic wrap. Now it has been about an hour, and as I said, this would probably strain against the plastic, and it sure has. This is why I'm actually grateful that I put the oil down, because this is now not sticking. This next step is what's called punching down the dough. Literally push your fist right into it and it deflates. Then we're going to ease it out of the bowl into this little pile of flour. And now we're simply going to knead this for another 5 minutes. It hasn't been quite 5 minutes, but this dough kind of feels right. It's gotten sticky again and it springs back well when I press into it. And what I did learn in that first proofing, which is what you call it when bread dough rises, is that this dough really wants to rise. Since I'm actually going to be making 2 loaves out of this, I think what I'm going to do now is divide this dough in half and proof it in 2 separate bowls. So I do have olive oil in the bottom of this bowl. Quickly form that into a ball, which you can see is actually big already. Roll it in that oil, and then we'll pop this one into its own bowl. See what I mean by sticky? But it still comes up clean. And we're gonna give that the same treatment. Roll it in the oil, make sure it's coated, and I want you to see the size of it in the bowl. Here you go. We are once again going to cover these each with plastic wrap and put it back in that warm, dry place to proof for another hour. While I wait for that bread to proof a second time, what I'm going to do is make the filling or the ripple that's going to go through these loaves of bread. What I have here is that 2.5 tablespoons of fresh parsley. I have 3 whole cloves of garlic. If you were buying your garlic from the grocery store, I would recommend 5 to 6, but these happen to be farm fresh and they have a much stronger flavor than the typical heads of, say, purple or elephant garlic that you get at most grocery stores. Here I have 1/2 cup of extra virgin olive oil. I also have some coarse kosher salt, which I will use only about 1 tablespoon of it. And I have 1 whole cup, which is 2 sticks, of unsalted butter. And the unsalted is important because salt will change the texture of your bread, which is why you have to choose carefully how to add it. Now I have my food processor right here, and I'm going to drop some of these chunks of butter in and get them down to more workable chunks. That was about 1/2 of the butter. We're going to add the garlic because it does need to be broken up. And this piece on a food processor allows a slow drizzle into what you are mixing. I can bring this in here. You can actually see the stream. We're just going to cover that just to keep it clean and just pop it over here for now. Then you can see it became a really pretty and easily movable spread. That's going to be key for when we go to our final proofing. Here we have 2 risen doughs, and I want you to notice that I said this dough really likes to rise, and it is very well risen. Now the idea here is to roll this into a rectangle as best as possible, nice and thin and long. Now that it's rolled out, you can actually see all of that beautiful parsley in there. And even if you look at these little yellow dots, that's actually the dried garlic. Now this butter mixture, which is again parsley, butter, olive oil and a little salt. We're going to divide this in half the best we can. And now spread a nice layer completely over the entire thing. Now that that's done, I have here some freshly grated Parmesan cheese. I'm going to use about half of it and sprinkle out a quick layer. We are going to roll this up exactly like a little Debbie Swiss cake roll. I'm going to take this new knife that my mother gave me for Christmas. We're going to fold this like this just so that we can figure out we have even sides cut right in the crease. Okay. Bring those ends together, but do not crimp them. And now simply braid it as if you were braiding hair. Now instead of crimping, just sort of tuck the ends in to each other. I have this, just a normal, regular size bread pan. I'm gonna give it a quick lazy spray with Pam. Take this, carefully curling the ends under. Look at how well, tuck it right into the sides. Let it spread out. And believe it or not, we are going to rise this dough again. So I will take this. Waste not, want not, right? And this will go into our warm, dry place once again for yet another hour. It's been about an hour on the third rising of the dough. I am about to go and get those loaves and see what they look like. And I have the oven preheated. We're at 400 degrees. Now I know you remember what these looked like when I put them into the pan. And let me just show you how much they've risen now. Completely filling the pan. Absolutely beautiful, gorgeous. These garlic parsley braid loaves are going into that 400 degree oven right now. They will be in there for about a half an hour, but in 15 minutes I'm going to come and rotate them so that they brown and rise evenly. These are ready and they're beautiful. And just as a warning to people who might be new to my channel, my oven was at 400 degrees, so when I open this, that smoke detector is going to go off. I love it when it makes a liar out of me. I'm going to take one of these loaves is going to my mother, so I'll tell you right now, Mom, this one's for you. And then this one is for us. First thing you do with a loaf of bread when you take it out of the oven is actually to get it out of the pan. Now, if you did it correctly, this is actually not a difficult maneuver. It should just tip right out. And this one does. Here it is, the final product. I'm gonna get a couple of slices here. This one is still warm. Look how it almost falls apart. You can see all of the delicious butter and parsley in here. And we're gonna give it a taste. Oh my God, that is fantastic. That is a garlic bread that you don't have to add anything to. It's ready to go. Thank you for joining me on Cooking for Real today, where I made a couple of these garlic parsley braided loaves. Nice addition to a Sunday dinner. Just slice it up and put it on the table. If you enjoyed watching Cooking for Real today, please remember to like, share, and subscribe, because I'm not only cooking for real, I'm cooking for you.